Dear students, today I am going to explain the new bit from topic enzyme catalysis. From catalysis, I am explaining today enzyme catalysis. First of all, what is meant by catalyst? That we have to see. Catalyst is a substance which alters the rate of chemical reaction. Either it may be changing, it may be increasing or decreasing. That foreign substance which is not taking part in a chemical reaction, that substance is called the catalyst. Means a catalyst is a substance which is increasing or decreasing the rate of chemical reactions. In the enzyme catalysis, we have to see how the enzymes are playing the role of catalysis. First of all, what is mean by enzyme? That we have to see. Enzymes are the nitrogenous organic compounds which are nothing but the complex protein molecules which are synthesized by the plants and animals in their body to catalyze the number of biochemical reactions which are going on continuously in the living system, as like the plants and animals. Means in the plants and animals there are different biochemical reactions are going on continuously. That biochemical reactions are catalyzed by complex protein molecules. That complex protein molecules are nothing but the enzymes. These are the enzymes which are secreted or synthesized and in the cells to perform the biological processes or the biochemical reactions. That complex protein molecules are nothing but the enzymes. These enzymes are produced at the cell level and that are catalyzing the different biochemical reactions in the living system. The number of enzymes are synthesized nowadays. First enzyme was synthesized in the laboratory in 1969. And some enzymes are synthesized or manufactured or prepared or analyzed from the cells in the crystalline form also. Means in short, enzymes are the complex protein molecules and which are responsible for the catalyzing the biological reactions in the living system. Such a biological or biochemical reactions which are catalyzed by the enzymes, that catalysis is called the enzyme catalysis. Then we have to see some examples of the enzyme catalysis. Now I am explaining one by one the different examples of the enzyme catalysis. Inversion of cane sugar by invertase enzyme present in yeast. C12H22O11, that is the cane sugar, in presence of invertase it forms the C6H12O6 plus C6 H12O6, that is glucose and fructose. Means in the inversion of cane sugar, invertase is an enzyme which play a role of catalyzing this reaction and forming the glucose and fructose, which have the same molecular formula but different structural formula. In this reaction, invertase is an enzyme, that is the complex protein molecule, that catalyzing the reaction, and hence this reaction is called the enzyme catalyzed reaction, and the process is called the enzyme catalysis. Second example, conversion of glucose into ethanol by zymase enzyme present in yeast. This is also present in the yeast. C6H12O6 This is the glucose. Which upon action with zymase forms the tris C2H5OH plus tris CO2. In this reaction, glucose is converted into the ethanol. For the conversion of glucose into ethanol, zymase enzyme is playing an important role. This conversion of glucose reaction is catalyzed by the enzyme and forming the ethanol from the glucose. Then third example, that is the hydrolysis of urea. This is the urea. Urea hydrolyzes and forming the ammonia. Enzyme which is used in this reaction, that is the urease. Urease is an enzyme which is used for the hydrolysis of urea. This is a urea, NH2, C double bond O, NH2. Upon hydrolysis, it in the presence of urease, it gives the ammonia and CO2. Means in these examples, these are the enzymes which are catalyzing the biochemical reactions in the living system. Such biochemical reactions which are catalyzed by the catalyst are called the enzyme biocatalyzed reactions or the enzyme catalyzed reactions, and the process is called the enzyme catalysis. How this enzyme catalysis is going to be done, that we have to see with the help of mechanism. In this case, these are the glucose and fructose. If it is not observable for you, this is the damage. Okay, then we have to see the mechanism of enzyme catalysis. And what are the different examples of the enzyme catalysis? I will show you at the end of the video. There are numerous biochemical reactions which are catalyzed by the different catalysts, different enzyme catalysts, as like the maltase, then trypsin, pepsin, and so on. That I am giving you at the end of the video in the form of study material. Now we have to see the mechanism, how the enzyme catalysis is working and enhancing the rate of biochemical reactions. Now we have to see the mechanism. In the enzyme catalysis, how the enzymes are forming the activated complex with the reactants and how they are reacting with each other, that is the reactants or the substrates, and forming the products, that we have to see. Protein molecules, that is the enzymes. Enzymes are the complex protein molecules which are the long chain organic compounds, and they are coiling over each other and forming a colloidal particle structure. That particle or that coiled protein molecule or the enzyme has a number of cavities on it. That cavities are associated with the number of active groups, as like the SH, COOH, OH, then NH2 group, and so on. Means that complex protein molecules, that is the enzymes, are coiling over each other, and due to the coiling over each other, or the being they are coiled over each other, they forming a colloidal particle like structures with the different cavities. That cavities are also with the active groups, as like the SH, COH, OH, NH2, and so on. And that cavities are playing a role as a active centers for the reactants or the substrates. Means, what happens? The complementary reacting species or the substrates are get fixed into the cavities which are formed on these complex protein molecules or the enzymes, and into that particular cavities, after forming an activated complex with the cavities and the active groups, that substrates or the reactants are forming the activated complex with the enzyme and gets reacted, and after reacting with each other, forming the products, and enzyme is set free as it is. It is explained by the Michelis and maintained in 1913 as this enzyme catalysis is explained in this way: E plus S giving the ES, and then it forms the E plus P. Where is the enzyme? S is the substrate or the reactant. S is a activated complex. Then E is the enzyme and P is a product. Means in this way enzyme is forming a activated complex with the substrate or the reactants. And this activated complex, on this activated complex, reaction is completed and the product is set free and enzyme is made available as it is for the further reactions and so on. This is explained with the help of lock and key theory. In this way, this is a substrate, this is a enzyme, it forms a activated complex in this way. That is ES. This ES is a decomposer and forming the E plus product in this way. Means substrate, this is the substrate which is fitting into the cavities of the enzymes which are complementary with the substrate. After fixing this reactant or the substrate into the enzyme, it forms a complex. This is an activated complex. This activated complex upon decomposition forming the product in this way and enzyme is set free as it is, which is playing the role of catalyst. Means catalyst is a substance, foreign substance. Due to its presence only, the rate of reaction is increasing. That substance is called the catalyst, and which will remain unchanged even after the end of the reaction. Means in this reaction also, enzyme is acting as a catalyst, hence it is called the enzyme catalyst. Enzymes are nothing but the complex protein molecules, which are long chain compounds, uncoiling over each other, they forming a colloidal-like structure, colloidal particle structure with the different cavities with the active groups. And that cavities are acting as a active centers with a particular shape. The substrate or the reactants with a particular shape gets fixed up into that cavities and forming the activated complex in this way. And after the reaction, the product is set free and the enzyme is also set free. In this way, it is explained by the Michaelis and Menten in 1930. This is the enzyme catalysis. Mechanism of enzyme catalysis also. Means in the enzyme catalysis, enzyme is reacting with the reactants of the substrates and forming a activated complex and gets reacted and forming the product and setting free enzyme as it is. This is a mechanism given by the Michaelis and Menten in 1930. Means in this case, we have seen the enzymes are the complex protein molecules which are derived by the cells in the living system to catalyze the biological reactions or biochemical reactions which are going on in the body of the plants or animals. That is called the, that complex protein molecules are called the enzymes. And the catalysis is called the enzyme catalysis. We have seen the different examples of the enzyme catalysis. Then we have seen the mechanism also of the enzyme catalysis, how enzyme catalysis is working. Then I will show you the different examples of the enzyme catalysis now.